All right, I wanted to show a quick video of the new Music Thing graphic EQ assembly, since there isn't really an assembly guide, and I understand why. This is about as Duplo DIY as it gets. Very simple, great for beginners. Check it out. PCB, all the surface mount's done already. Even the power header is done for you. So, how does it go together? Put the pots in the board. Like so. Preferably not break the pot. Input and output jacks. Panel. Like so. Always good to have a little knurl driver. And just solder. Just make sure when you solder in the slider pots that they're in all the way. Flush against the circuit board. So those look pretty good. Because the last thing you want is one of your faders to be up higher than the others. Just rotate this a little bit. One thing you have to be a little careful with these is the pads are a little small. These are very small pads. I use the stock chiseled tip from Hayco. Tends to work really well for me for the most part. In this case, not so much. So, to that I say larger pads. There's plenty of room here. So I have to kind of come at it from a little more vertical angle. using a no wash solder as well, which has a little less flux. So but hopefully this won't be too kludgy blobs. These are the last two pads. And that's all there is to this with regards to the soldering. I'm just going to touch up my joints here. Yeah, I think that's going to be my only complaint with this kit, is that the pads are so small. I'm just doing cosmetic cleanup at this point. Not used to having my face so far away. Just want to give it a good visual inspection. Tricky, those little pads. Just need a little extra attention, that's all. So what is left is, and this is something I don't necessarily agree with, but just be careful. There are no spacers. Again, I'm not working off of any build documentation or anything. This has not been updated yet. But I'm kind of the opinion that there should be a spacer between the pot and the panel. There's just not enough room to raise the faders up. There's not enough lead length on the faders to raise them up against the panel to kind of do this the way that it should be done. But there really shouldn't be any open space behind the fader when installing these screws. I'd actually say you could go without them, but the screw holes are there, so might as well take advantage. But because there's nothing actually firmly behind the panel, these are subject to becoming loose again in the future, and you don't want to screw too hard, otherwise you'll do upward pressure. You'll basically separate and pull the frame of the slider off of the actual potentiometer if you tighten it too hard. And perhaps I'm assembling this incorrectly or not as intended, but so you just want to kind of do these just gently, just snug. You don't want to bend the panel or anything like that. But that's it. That's all there is to this. Pretty quick build. Less than 10 minutes, it would appear. You can get these at modularaddict.com or thonk.co.uk. They retail around $75-$80 USD. Fun little module, simple. I recommend it. That's it.